Hey guys, I got to go out and check a beehive here pretty quick, but I thought I would show you. I got to get this tea going here, my hibiscus tea. I'll have this steeping while I'm out working the bees. So what I do here is the old bun coffee maker. Dump that in there, let that drain through. That's how I get my hot water. Now let's see what I got here. Hibiscus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 of them. 9 of those. And let's see what we got here. Motherwort. I work with about 20 of these tinctures. I've been doing this quite a few years now. I think about 6 or 7 years I've been playing with this stuff. I've been doing bees, honeybees, holistically for longer than that. But I started doing Stevo holistic, 6, 7 years ago. And let's see, 1 dropper full of the old motherwort. All of these tinctures, saw palmetto. All of these tinctures, I'm going to put 2 shots of that. I wildcraft this too on certain years. This saw palmetto, we have saw palmetto here, Florida. And I'll go out and wildcraft this, but in the last few years, I only got like 15 berries last year. I made a small batch with it. And learn how to do this self-care. I call it self-care. Hawthorn berry. I'm not going to tell you guys what this stuff does, okay? I want you to do your own homework. Get out there and do your own homework. And I suggest you go to Rosemount Herbs. And they're out of Oregon. I'm not affiliated with them or whatsoever, but that's where I get my herbs. I get them in bulk. I'll get like a pound at a time. Stinging nettle. Okay, I'm going to put a little stinging nettle in this. A little splash of that. Damiana. Excellent stuff. Check this stuff out. See what it does. And you'll know. Do your homework, alright? So, I'm going to pour this hot water now all over this stuff. I'm going to let her steep for the full length of time that I'm out working the bees. And then when I come back in, I'm going to be hot. And I'm going to want, and then what I'll do, see, I left it down. So I'm making a concentrate, basically, here. I'm making this a concentrate. And this will be like really pink. It's already getting pink with all that in it. That'll be some real pretty stuff. And there's a lot of benefit. You can get dried hibiscus flower, by the way, too, at Rose Mountain. All this stuff you can get. All right. And what I'll do, I just get this in my local shop. Sweet leaf. I use stevia. Sometimes I put a little honey in, but honey, I only use that like as medicine. And you'll see, I'm going to do a show on treatments. I think I'll call this show One for Me and One for the Bees. I'll show you how I do my essential oils for the bees. And I'm going to show you what I do to keep my arteries cleaned out. You know, a lot of people are dying with strokes and heart attacks. Yeah, I'm out here working, hunting, and fishing. I don't have time, folks, for heart attacks and strokes, okay? So this is what Steve-O does. You guys do what you want to do, but I suggest you start doing, self-care instead of health care, all right? So, yeah, that's a little tip there. Now, I'm going to shut down, and we're going to go out and work the bees here. And then I'll come back in and enjoy this tea. I'll see you in a bit. Okay, guys, we're out here on the bees. This hive, this box here was over here in this position right here at this one, okay, yesterday. I'm converting everything to medium equipment. This is a deep 8-frame box. I'm done with fooling around with deep boxes. Matter of fact, all these deep frames, I went in yesterday and butchered every one of, with the ones that I could, the rest of, there were some others in there that I didn't fool with. I just butchered them down. They do not have a bottom bar, but that's fine. they're going to get the, this is going to get incorporated into this other hive we're setting up. Now it's been 30 days. I'm going to, by the way, take that A-frame and I'm going to put on table saw. I'm going to make sure I don't hit the nails on the table saw. I'm going to pull those nails. I'm going to cut that thing down to a medium size. I do have some other medium stuff over here, but yeah, this here, see the date here, it says 4/18. Well, today's 4/18, it's been a month. But everything looks hunky-dory here, because I'm seeing there just went one in just then. Pollen, they're bringing in pollen. That's a good indicator that this hive is nice and happy, okay? It's been 30 days. I should have a mated queen back in here. You'll see it as I'm seeing it. I do not touch a hive until 30 days. Do not fool around in these hives, I'm telling you, because you're going to mess up these queens. And the reason I'm going to change this box out, this bottom box, to this box, because I've got a little bigger hole in there, entry hole. I came out here last night. These things were all bearded up. They were having a heck of a time getting in here. They're rushing in before nightfall and to get in the house. These girls are sucking up a lot of syrup, all right, which is fine. All right. So yeah, that's what I want to do. I want to spec this box. And now the 26th, so far all my hives, I've got two over here, I've got one at the other yard. And if this one here comes in queen right, I have got everybody queen right. Everything's fine. All these girls are laying good. So on the 26th, what I do, these girls look a little pissy here. Oh, they get cranked up already. This ought to be fun. Anyway, I do not make up queens until new moon. I make up my queens. I've done this forever, and I've tried to do it the other ways, and I've had not good luck. So I want to make up my queens between new moon and full moon. So I think the 26th is that. So I'll come back on the 26th, which is, I think, next Wednesday, and go through here and see who I can make up. And to make up a five-frame nuke, what I do is take two planes. We'll go over this on the deal, man, the makeup. I'm going to put in two planes like this. Okay? I'm going to take one frame of nothing but honey and pollen drop in here on the outside. I'm going to take two frames of just about, with bees and all, the bees will come from whatever hive I'm stealing from. They'll be slid in. The first thing I do is plug the entrance. Now, when I'm making up colonies that are weak, I will have a small hole. Now, if you want to take a big hole and make a smaller, put a piece of duct tape across here, put across your pant leg or whatever, knock the sticky off, but have sticky on each side, and just reduce it down a little bit. Okay, you want a minimal hole so they can guard it. All right, back to this. You put the honey and pollen frame in. Bees and all. You grab another frame, it's just about solid sealed brood. You want that in your nuke. You're going to leave the queen. You can take the queen to the other side, or you can leave her here. Now, if I take, what I'm probably going to do is leave all these queens here. I'm going to take these nooks, queenless nooks, over to my other yard. That one at the other yard, I'm going to make up and bring back here. See, I'm flopping them back and forth. So you take a frame that's full about solid brood, and with just a few eggs, and then try to get another one with solid brood. And the theory is there, they're going to be hatching soon to reinforce this box. Okay, because you want a strong box. You're going to feed this nuke, because if you feed it, the girls will produce a lot of royal jelly. And you got to pump the royal jelly to these queen's cells that they're making. Otherwise, you'll have a not so good queen. So you want plenty of syrup coming in. You can do it on a flow if you got a good nectar source flow that you know is happening. You can do that, but I would suggest also feeding the bees as you're making up your own queens. Now you can really kick this bee operation up in a hurry if you want to buy queens. You could put in. Come over here and put in one pollen frame, honey and pollen. You could put in one brood frame and some queens, and go to the next, go to the, take them to the other yard, and then the next day, if you've got queens, already bred queens, you could, or cells, but queens would be a really fast way to build up, but they're $30 a pop. I'm making queens for free. I'm not spending no money, okay? So you can do that too. All right, let's get into this hive and see what we got here. Sometimes with these frames, the girls sometimes can make a screwed up mess in here. They don't. So what you do is you know, if they don't build it out quite right. And now here's a frame here. It's just about solid honey, capped honey. That's a beautiful frame. That will be a frame that I may rob, but it doesn't have a lot of pollen, and I like pollen to go with my nooks to the next site. That one's not too swift. Let's see what we got here. These girls, I'm telling you right now, they need elbow room. They don't have enough room in here. I'm looking in these cells right now for eggs. There's a lot of drone cell there. A lot of drone cell right there. I'm not seeing no eggs in that. Probably all the egg actions down below. Now here's a nice frame. This one would be an excellent frame. The false queen cell. This would be an excellent frame to put in a nuke, because see, you've got a lot of pollen, you've got honey. This would be an excellent frame for that. Here's slap full of honey. I could actually go ahead and cut out some of this comb. I just give my comb honey away for gifts. Friends, you know, family and friends. There's another beauty. This is beautiful. But now I'm feeding these things. And a lot of this nectar is basically sugar water. I mean, but you know, they convert it. And I'm going to put this one, move this box over. Box over here. So far, I haven't seen any eggs. Front end of this hive. I like to work off the side. You get toward the front end of the hive, they get, they're not happy with that. Get a bit of pollen here. And honey. And I'm seeing eggs. Okay. Eggs. So we have a success story here, folks, on this beehive. So far, Steve-O has had 100% success rate. The thing I'm not too happy with is the temperament of these bees right now. I mean, they're not super bad, but they're not gentle kittens either, I can tell you that. All right, this frame's not bad. It's a homemade frame there. This one's going in. Let's see if I can find old baby grub here. I don't see her yet. I like to look at queens. You know, there's some of them are dark colored and some are really bright yellow. I don't see her yet. There's a false queen cell there, no egg in it. That's good. In the spring of 18, I will come into all my hives just as soon as I see plenty of drones. I'm going to kill every one of my queens. And you're probably going, oh my God, what is this guy doing? He's killing all the friggin' queens. Here's my theory on this. Second year queens are more than likely going to swarm. You get a swarm, guess what? You watch about a basketball size of bees go flying out of this box and go up on a limb 50 foot in friggin' air. I don't know what's going on with bees these days. They used to swarm low. I could walk up a lot of, they still do a little bit, but I lost four hives. They leave enough back to where, you know, they need a lot back to build up another hive. But you lost those bees. You've lost bees, and guess what? When that big old basketball size of bees flies off, you might as well drive down the road and throw a $100 bill right out the window, because that's exactly what you've done. You've lost that hive. You've lost those bees. So what I'll do is come in before before they start to do their swarming thing. And if I see swarming cells, that's fine. I will leave some swarming cells in there. I haven't seen this queen. She may be down in this box here. So what I'll do, I'll come in here and kill all these queens. But I'm not going to throw those queens away. What I do is I put them in a little bottle of vodka. And then I take a chopstick, I'll come down through what many hives I've got, and I'll pinch them queens and throw them in that vodka. And then I will take a chopstick and go in there and chop them up. Then I'm going to put one or two drops of lemongrass in that bottle. Guess what I just created, folks? Swarm lure. Now I'll take that swarm lure, I'll shake it up, and I'll dip a Q-tip in there, and I'll throw it inside hives that are sitting out. I've used for traps. Here she is right there. I'll be darned. There's that queen right there. She's in the bottom of this box right here. I wish she hadn't have done that. Let me see if I can get her to walk up on my hive tool here. There she is right there. There she is. She walked right down in there. Just as sweet. Sweet as can be. A bee that's sweet as can be. I'm going to go over here and get some more of these frames. I'm going to get a couple of these. Because if you don't use these up, wax moth will come in and just chew everything up. All right, I'm going to move this guy over. All right. Plop it in between here. And I'm also, these guys need room bad. I mean, really bad. These things need room to expand. So what I'm going to do here is take this box here. Bam! Now you stir them up. Okay. Now, easy to get these back. All right, I'm going to give these girls some more room here. Thank you. calm this mess down a little bit here. One just got right inside my veil and nailed me right through the temple. Anyway, settle down, girls. Settle down. I'm going to go over and get another box and put on this thing. I'm going to move a couple of these up. Get one more box on here. They need elbow room badly. So that's what I'm going to do. And, yeah. Let this go. Now, I'll come back next week. I'm going to show you guys how to get this splits done. This is not a happy hive, folks. Okay? I may just kill this queen later. I got to get some more hives made. I got to get some more equipment drawn out. And I may terminate some queens. And I got a buddy down the road here to my north. And he's a breeder. And I may just bite the bullet and buy some. Because I've got obviously a higher, percentage of Africanized. Which you're going to have in Florida. You can't get away from killer bees. They're here to stay. So all us beekeepers can do is work with what you have and try to tame them down. And you do that by breeding your better, calmer bees. Oh yeah, look at that tea. It's got like a pink, like pink lemonade. That hibiscus tea with all the goodies I put in. Man, that stuff is great. Let me try a shot of this. Man, is that good. Yeah, glad you guys stopped by. Get with me next week. By Wednesday, we're going to get into these and start busting these hives up. I want to start getting, I'll get four hives, production hives. Let's go in and split them up. I think I got plenty of equipment over there. We'll start making up some more nooks. We'll jump this thing from four hives to eight hives. You can just every month start making more hives. You can turn this thing into a monster. Now, them little girls back there were kind of a little monster today. You never know. These guys, like I say, they go out, you take Italian queens, European bees, they go out and mate with the African, and you can get some mean bees. It can happen, but you can get into some serious stuff with these bees now, but don't ever panic. If you're getting chewed up with the bees, all right, they're coming in. I found out where they were coming in on mine. They were coming in down in my boot. I had one little hole down there, and they're crawling into that hole and coming right up through into my veil. One got me in the nose, one got me on the temple. I can take quite a few hits, but it's still painful. So, you make sure you're secured up. And when you're in some mean bees now, tell you a little story. I was up in the Gulf hammock, and I had one of my sidekicks with me, and now he'd been smoking. He was shoving a cigarette. He had a little hole in the veil, shoving that cigarette in there, smoking while working bees. Well, we got into a situation. We got a lot of robbing going on. It was my dumb fault. I took up some wet boxes, and them bees were hitting those, and we had to offload bees, so they were pissed off with that, and then this robbing scenario started. I was completely engulfed in bees. The only thing that saved my hiney, I had to back off. I had a hooded sweatshirt. They were just ripping my neck. I was taking hundreds of hits through the neck, and I told the boys, there was two other helpers, they got knocked out of commission real quick. This bee started getting into their crappy equipment. They walked down the road, went into the woods. I lost them two guys. And then my other sidekick was in there with me. He'd been smoking through that veil. Well, he started getting covered up with bees. And I had backed off and got a hooded sweatshirt because they were hammering on my neck so bad. And then I just doused myself with ice water. And put that on, and I waded right back into him. I had to get him off the truck. I mean, it was just the whole truck was engulfed with bees. So I was taking the bees off, and I had a little Kelly boom that I'd made up, a hive lifter, a 12-volt lifter, and I was snatching them off there with that thing. And Anyway, I heard some screaming. I looked over. Here's my sidekick. He's laying on the ground. He's got both fists, and he's pounding on his face. He had totally lost it. He panicked, okay? You never panic in this scenario. You start getting hammered on bees, you start walking away. You go over, you crawl in the woods, do whatever you got to do. You walk away from the area. He panicked. Now, he would have died. But it just so happened, a buddy of mine was in the area, and they were out jolly riding around, him and his sidekick, and he happened to pull in his pickup truck. And he pulled right up next to me just when the chaos hit. And I ran. I waved him over real quick because my buddy's flip-flopping around, looked like a beach mullet there on the ground. And I dropped the tailgate. He pulled up next. My adrenaline was pumping so hard. I picked this dude up and literally threw him in the back. Now, he weighed as much as I did. Weight was no issue with me at the time because I was pumping. Okay, I picked him up and slammed him in the back of that truck, jumped in, hit the top of the hood. I said, punch it. So we went out of there. I'm standing up. He's going down the road in about 50 mile an hour, and I'm blowing these bees off me. Well, my buddy's still on the floor. He's screaming, flopping around. He's almost in shock. We get down the road. I ripped the veil off of him. He had a jug of water. My buddy had a jug of water. I splashed it on his face, and I started digging stingers out of his face. So that gives you a little tune-up on bees. Don't panic, all right? You can always walk away. Go walk away. These things can get you down and they will kill you. All right? But our goal here is not, my goal here is not to scare you. It's just to tell you some of the stuff that can happen and get in a situation. When you're in that situation, walk away from the bees, okay? And that's pretty much wraps up the show. I'll get with you next week and we'll get into these hives and we will start making up some splits. Now, as always, I want you to be happy. And I'll catch you on the next show. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye.